we have to go through Zero to secure making it out of groups.
Uzi is cutting through G2. Perks get out for free, but it's G2 who pay the price.
It's gonna be important to stay mentally strong and try and make it all the way.
I think we stood a good fight, but we did a lot of mistakes and we paid for them.
How cruel would this be after how well 1907 Fenerbahce has played?
If we can improve ourselves, I think we have a good chance at taking our revenge.
2차 목표는 작년을 제외하는 거예요. 그냥 2차부터 결승 갈 때까지 한 번도 지고 싶지 않아요.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the beautiful city of Wuhan, host of the World's 2017 group stage. With our quarterfinalists being decided yesterday, the pressure is now on teams in Group C to advance to the knockout stage. The fans have packed this arena to the brim as the 3-0 RNG take to the stage today. The LPLs hope to challenge those other undefeated Korean teams. G2, of course, Sven and the rest of the crew unloading into the arena. More shots of the fans here. Plenty of passion to fill this room. Hello, everyone. I'm James Ash Patterson, joined by Indiana Frostgarden Black, Chris Papa Smithy Smith, and Joshua Jat Leesman. Yesterday was an insane eight-game day. Have you guys gotten some rest, reset? You ready to go for today?
Absolutely. We came in for the final leg of the cast yesterday. Eight games, we'd never had a three-way tiebreaker in a group stage for the World Championship. It happened yesterday, and there's an outside chance it happens again today.
Well, I agree with you, Jack. I was hopped up right at the end because of the intensity, because of how many games we went, trying to calm down. But today is going to be crazy, too.
What a way to start the week. Yesterday, we saw some dramatic fights in Group B as Fnatic managed to pull off a historic comeback to qualify for the knockout stage after two tiebreaker games against Immortals and the Gigabyte Marines.
And that's the thing. They started week one 0-3, but they effectively came back from an 0-4 deficit to then march through, win four more games, win the tiebreakers, and take their spot in the quarterfinals.
Yeah, and something that made that entire crazy day possible with a three-way tie 2-4 was Immortals losing all of their games. It was a really bad day for Immortals and North America in general. Flashbacks to 2015 where they went 0-10 in the second week after a 6-3 first week. There were the beginnings of that, so it was not a good day for Immortals, to say it like.
And the eight-game day started with a possibility of the first two games deciding everything. But Gigabyte Marines, they came back in. They won our hearts again with them showing they could take down Immortals. And they started a cascade of crazy that led to the insane day.
Lucky for NA, we don't play today. But let's talk about this Gigabyte Marines squad and what they have done here at Worlds. One of the most exciting teams to watch.
Yeah, huge congratulations to the Gigabyte Marines. Yes, they dropped. They didn't get to make their march towards the quarterfinals. But they have just done so much between this year, MSI and Worlds. Huge shout out to their coach Tenakun. Everything this guy seems to touch turns to gold. This was also the coach on Bangkok Titans when they made their IWCQ run. So he has a proven track record. He's shown it now at Worlds, and I can't wait to see what he has next.
And while we say goodbye to them on the same day, Longzhu continued their winning streak to go 6-0 in the group stage. LCK champions are looking to keep their form going into the quarterfinals here.
And they're doing it a bit of a different way. They did it in the LCK. LCK Khan was the man. We always talked about him, the top lane focus. Turns out that if you give shields and resources to Prey, he'll do the same thing. He can be that big carry. And to me, he's been a step above even the other great AD carries we have here at Worlds.
Well, after yesterday's results, Fnatic will be advancing from Group B along with the first seed, Longzhu. Turning to Group C, though, which will be decided today, Royal Never Give Up are sitting on top after going undefeated last week.
Yeah, and only 6% of the pick'em brackets are actually still alive after the crazy results that we had yesterday. And that probably will get a little bit thinner after today.
I know mine got destroyed. Yeah. It was looking good after week one, and then
you
yesterday.
You are not the 6%, Dash.
No, I am not the 6%. But Royal Never Give Up. They can clinch a spot in the knockout stage today with their first clash against G2 Esports. If they lose, however, their road does become a bit harder.
And this is the thing, RNG have come out swinging, looking very dominant, but today I'm going to pump the brakes a little bit. I think today might be the day that they get figured out.
Yeah, and it's going to be so tricky because as we saw yesterday, and I think we've seen a lot in Week 2 of Worlds, how you show up on the day and how you start the day matters so much because you do not have very long to recover, and I haven't even seen that much improvement or fall off from teams between game to game in these 3-game days.
And as a reminder, each team from Group C will play 3 games, with the 2 quarterfinalists being decided by the end of the day. Let's go ahead and take a closer look at today's contenders, though, starting with the LPL's Royal Never Give Up, who are on top of the standings with 3 straight wins.
Yeah, they're sitting on that 3-0. RNG are clearly very good. The thing about Chinese teams specifically is I always watch and I feel like these teams are always hyped coming into Worlds. Yet you see them at Worlds and you see critical micro mistakes, critical macro mistakes. Decision making can go up and down. This particular team, though, I look at them and I see clean play. I see a 35-minute group invade to clear out a blast cone to make Baron not an objective they'll take down. And suddenly I feel like, compared to these other teams of recent years, the LGDs of the Worlds a couple of years ago that came in big favorites, RNG, based on Week 1, are showing me something I haven't seen before.
Let's hear it, Frost. What do you got?
You completely agree.
A Korean analyst hyping up my teams?
I don't know.
Did you just want to do my job for me?
I'm aghast.
No, here's my thing, though. What I see is I actually see the typical LPL. I don't think this is any different than what RNG have shown. In fact, I think it's actually slower. Normally in the LPL, they were sprinters. Here, they've now been more of marathon runners. You see these massive gold spikes at around the 18 to 20 minute marks, which, surprise, surprise, that's around the team fighting. And this is my issue with RNG. I think they've been insulated by this group because Samsung and G2 let them get to that team fighting. Mm. They're not necessarily contesting them. G2 had a good early game run against them and didn't have the decisiveness to close. I think that's all about to change, and I think RNG are about to hit some speed bumps.
I think that's a possible read. It's a defender's meta. I think other teams, we knew Samsung and G2 would opt into that. The fact that RNG can play defensive, to me, defensive requires the restraint, requires you to give up resources, requires you to give up objectives. We've seen other teams fail that I would have thought at this tournament could do it. Samsung getting run over by RNG was a great example. So me seeing that kind of forms the whole for me. That's where I get the optimism. Again, based on 3-game samples.
Right, Jad, what's your take on this? Because, you know, on one side of the coin, there's criticism thrown mm-hmm. towards Samsung and G2 as being underperforming and therefore making it hard to judge how good RNG really is.
Yeah, it is hard to judge. What we know is they've executed on the style they brought here very well. They got Janna all 3 games, and that really enabled Uzi in the late game team fights. Plus the rest of the team has been performing. And when I look at Samsung, yes, they are a team from the LCK, and those teams almost always do amazingly. 82% win rate in every group stage. 9 of the 10 teams since we switched to this format have gotten out of group as first seed. But this Samsung team has more warning signs of a collapse than I have seen since we switched to this format.
Papa, your take on the Samsung roster.
Again, just knowing which jungler is going to be subbing in is a big story. We know right now that Ambition will be playing in Game 1 against 1907 Fenerbahce. The loss, oh, sorry, it feels like a loss in my head. It was a victory.
It was a struggle.
It was a win, right? It didn't feel like a win at the time. That was with Haru. So having his shot calling in, I don't think Ambition will play all 3 games today, but having his shot calling in does show up weaknesses. But RNG found different weaknesses when they took down Ambition. So is that the solution? We need more data.
All right, well, we'll soon find out. We move right along to the EU LCS champions in G2 Esports. They haven't been able to take down the top 2 teams. That is something they'll have to do today if they want to advance, though.
Exactly. The possibility of the 3-way tie is there if G2 wins 2 games. And I don't want to undersell this team because all the conversation has been about RNG and Samsung. Early game-wise, with the early laning from Zven and Mythi taking turrets with Triss, Lulu in 2 of their games, they have some of the best early game stats of anyone in the group stage, but they have faltered and failed finding fights in the late game. That isn't necessarily an easy fix, but it's definitely not something I could completely rule out.
And again, it's that idea that when you look at their holistic score, you don't necessarily see the strength of G2. They had an excellent early game against RNG, and they were the one team that really ran into full power Samsung. Since then, Crown has not had the same performance, so things should be looking a lot better for G2 if Samsung continue to shake.
Now, one team that's looking to crash the party is 1907 Fenerbahce, who almost managed to take down that struggling Samsung Galaxy last week.
And it feels like a bit of a struggle to say they'll play more than spoiler here, because compared to Fnatic, they don't necessarily have the communication set out. They don't necessarily have the talent there to match a team like Fnatic. But yesterday was such a surprise that they could still play a pivotal role, even if we won't be announcing them as a team exiting.
Yeah, when we talk about the possibility of a three-way tie for first, that means every single game has to go a specific way, which would mean 1907 losing every single one of those games. So as soon as they do one thing that deviates from that script, the possibilities are gone.
All right, okay, well, there you have it. As the first game is getting closer, I'm going to challenge you, analysts, to tell me which two teams are going to make it out of the group and why. Frost?
Okay, so I'm going to go on a limb here, and I'm going to put my voting power behind the Korean dominance of week two. I think Samsung are going to show much better this time around. I think they're actually going to surge through and grab hold of first place. Okay. Behind them will be RNG, but if Samsung are playing well enough that they can grab first place, then it'll come to a tiebreaker between them and RNG, and if Samsung are on a roll, they're probably going to win that anyway. So
that
Samsung,
buffer,
RNG.
Not enough. Papa Smithy, what are you thinking?
I'm with you on the Korean dominance part, but not the Samsung dominance. There are two other great Korean teams here, and Samsung need to show me more to have faith in a prediction. I can't look at stories of last year and their improvement without actually seeing it for myself now. RNG has shown me a lot, so I think RNG gets out of this group. Samsung and G2 are going to battle hard, but Samsung, I think, with their 2-1, if they'd lost to Fenerbahce, I definitely would have been considering other things. But right now, RNG first, Samsung second.
Same two teams flip the order. Jet?
Yeah, I find it so interesting that Samsung does control their own destiny. If they win out, they're first in the group for sure. But when I talk about the warning signs I saw last week, the game that Ruler had against RNG, 98 damage per minute, never being able to get involved. Their early games have actually not struggled that much. They had a huge lead against 1907 before nearly losing that game. That's not the control you come to expect from a Korean team. And I've tried to do this many times before where I'm like, it's not the whole region that's great. It's this one team that's really good, and the second team that's really good, and the third team's not so good.
Right.
This year, that circular logic could actually be true.
Okay.
Don't count out G2. The reason I don't have G2 above Samsung, because I actually have no faith in this Samsung team, is this game we have on stage right at the start of the day. If RNG takes down G2, that moves them to 1-3 and makes it nearly impossible for them to get out. But I think G2 could actually take a game off of Samsung as well.
The importance of those records from week one playing into that. The stage is set for a close fight between the teams in Group C. Let's leave it a quick shot, Betis and Kobe, to get us into the game.